praise Him. Amen. All right, just a word of prayer. Just bow your heads. Father, we thank you for your ability, your strength. Father, you're the Lord that healeth all of our diseases. You forgiveth all of our iniquities. We thank you that you are working today. You are at work. You are working your will and the ability to do your good pleasure in us. We give you praise. We give you the glory for every good and every perfect gift. All out from above. We thank you, Father, for beginning the good work within us. And you who have begun the good work shall continue to reward our eyes upon you. You are the author, you are the finisher. We give you praise and glory today for every good. Hallelujah. Every good and perfect thing coming from you. We thank you today, Lord, that Satan, his power is broken, his dominion has come to an end. He's a defeated foe. He's under our feet. Hallelujah. And Jesus has already triumphed. Hey, Father, we thank you that the name of Jesus is the name that's prevailing today. Hey, la la la. That's the source of our strength. Lord, you're the strength of our life. You're the light of our salvation. We are complete in you. Hey, great peace have they that love your law. Lord, we thank you for those who delight in you. Those that who delight in you, you will give them the desires of their heart. Father, we thank you today for your word. Oh, your healing word, your saving word, your peace-giving word. Lord, there is joy in the word. There's life in the word. There's life to them. Oh, life to them that find it. Hey, Lord, we thank you that your word is still the same yesterday, today, and forever. Lord, you change not. In you there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Oh God, you still give strength to the faint. Hey, ha ha ha. And to them that have no might, you increase their strength. And they that wait upon you, Lord, hey, shall renew their strength. They shall not run away as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. We give you praise and we give you the glory. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. For all that you have done, all that you are doing. Hallelujah. We thank you. We praise you today. And we give you the glory that's due your name. And we worship you, Father, in the beauty of holiness today. And we thank you for all of your blessings. Jesus. Amen. We just thank God for His presence today. The scripture says, in His presence. Everybody just say, in His presence. Amen. In His presence, there is what? Fullness of joy. Amen. How many get the joy that the Bible talks about, the joy that's unspeakable? The joy that's unspeakable and full of glory. Full of glory. Amen. I thank God for joy. Amen. Scripture says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Amen. Praise God. I just thank God for the Spirit of the Lord. Just wanted to say before I get into the message today that this is going to be a glorious week. We're going to do a whole lot of things this week. We're going to reach out to a lot of people. I'm going to share with you how we're going to do it. Amen. And we're going to assemble to the house of the Lord on a daily basis. Amen. Sometimes we need to refuel. We need to be rejuvenated. We need to be restored. We need to be motivated. We need to be inspired. And we want to really begin to focus on worship. Amen. Because that's going to be the strength and the motivation and the inspiration that's going to let us out into really reaching people that we have never reached before. Amen. We got some plans that are already at work and they're already working. Amen. So I want you to make a sacrifice. Everybody just say, this is sacrifice time. Amen. Amen. No, I'm not excited about that. This is sacrifice time. Amen. So we're going to expect you to get out of your beds. Amen. Let the comfortable, what type of mattresses you have that's real comfortable. Amen. Whatever they are, we want you to release yourself. Amen. Around 4 o'clock, 4:30. 4:15, and make a special effort to get up. We want to do a lot of things. We want you to make sure you have your meditation book. Those of you that still have your meditation book, we're going to do the word. We're going to affirm the word. We're going to pray the word. We're going to sing the word. We're going to do it all. Amen. We're just going to worship ourselves happy. Amen. We're going to worship ourselves into victory. We're going to be praying for everybody that have a vision, a dream. You might be in a business. You might have some creative ideals, some things that God has revealed to you. This is going to be the time that those things are going to begin to take root. And God is going to put some, amen, some, I would say, some revelation and some inspiration, amen, to those dreams you had for a long time. Amen. I don't know about you, amen. I'm almost at the tip. I'm at the brink of a great breakthrough. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I'm at the brink of a great breakthrough. I just believe it. Because I think it starts in the spirit realm. How many believe it starts in the spirit realm? When you get your spiritual breakthrough, you are right at the door for your financial breakthrough. For whatever your ministerial breakthrough or whatever breakthrough that you need. I'm going to be working really hard to eradicate or to erase a whole lot of these sad looking countenances and faces this week. Amen. I want to help your faces. I want to bless your countenance this week. Amen. With the Lord's help. Amen. Amen. We're going to pray and rejoice and share the word and pray the word and praise God until you get shouting glad. Amen. Amen. We're going to wonder where the frowns went. Amen. When you get a good dose of rejoicing and praising God. We're just going to give the word of God and the spirit of God and worship priority this week from 5 to 6 or 5 to 6:30. We're going to endeavor to be here this week. Amen. So I'm not looking for anybody to be in charge. We're going to put God in charge. And I'm going to be here to open the door. Amen. Praise God. All right. At 7 o'clock each evening, we're going to focus on prayer. Amen. 7 to 8. 7 to 8. So make sure you have your meditation book. Everybody say meditation book. If you don't have it, you are sold it. Shared it, whatever you've done. Lost it. Well, we got something back on the table there. We'll share with you for a small amount. These books are used all over America, even and even in foreign countries. A lot of people love these books. A lot of people have got healed from these books all over. A lady called me on my way back from St. Louis. She said, I was looking for you. Somebody told me you were here. She said that your material has meant so much to us. I mean, this was a pastor's wife. Amen. Not just her, but we have many, 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 many people. Now, it's really sad that people all over, they really cherish this, but many of you, some of you don't even have it. It's kind of odd, isn't it? Amen. So it will be made available today. Also, you that need your prevailing prayer, confession, and declaration book, this is your prayer book. Everything we are doing, we are going to do it by the word. Pray the word. Sing the word. Rejoice in the word. Amen. So we do have a few prayer books in the rear if you need a prayer book. Amen. We are going to begin to lay the foundation for something that we've never tried to do it this way, but I just believe this is ordered of the Lord. I know it is ordered of the Lord. We're going to, amen, ask you to focus very heavily on, I think, the most important area that's I can think of that's designed to build your faith. Amen. It's going to start with prayer. It's going to start with praying the word. It's going to start with what? Praying in the spirit. It's going to start with, amen, building your life around the word of God. Amen. There's no need for us to be so empty, so void, and so, you know, out there and not really in the flow of what God wants to do. Amen. I've been ministering on something I feel that's very vital, and I'm going to focus this week, and I'm going to be giving you incidents, stories, demonstrations, illustrations, even in the mornings and in the evenings, off the area that I'm going to be focusing. I'm going to focus on the area that the Lord has begun to deal with us on, the Lord's compassion. Until we feel comfortable that God is for us, God is trying to keep us from enjoying His blessings and His benefits. You know, many times people grown up under certain conditions and atmosphere, they don't feel like nobody care about them. They don't feel like, they feel like God is against them, the devil is against them, and everybody's against them. Amen. Sometimes atmospheres and environments kind of lend itself for people to feel that, amen, they are not really, there's nobody that really loves me and cares for me. Amen. But we just have to get beyond all of those mental blocks and all of those the past and understand that the prerequisite for God's blessings is that you got to be absolutely sure that God is good, that He loves you, and He cares a whole lot for you. And He wants you blessed more than you even desire to be blessed. And that is the reason and the motivation behind preaching about the Lord's greatest attribute, which is compassion, that we've been sharing with you. Amen. I do believe that we're going to flow from compassion because it's going to build a foundation for faith. And we've studied faith for the last several weeks. But we're going to try to put this in perspective and really build on what we have already taught for several weeks. Faith, how faith works. We talked about confession. We talked about meditation, verbalization, and amen, and all of the things that are attributed to building the faith. Now, I want you to look at the scripture that we started with, Psalms 145. Just going to take my time because we're going to be doing a whole lot of focusing this week about building our lives around the Word of God. And the scripture that we shared with you concerning the Lord's compassion was Psalms 145. Amen. Psalms 145. And I believe that this is the time for us to perfect our praise, perfect our worship, to get in a position where God can actually release His mercies, His blessings into your life. Psalms 145, I want you to read the scripture that we started with a few weeks ago. This is Psalms 145, verses 8 and 9. Everybody just turn there. Another thing I just wanted to say is that God quickened to me the other day that we really need to begin to focus and prepare our hearts for the coming of Christ. It's just something is in the air that points to the imminence of the coming of Christ. Amen. If something goes wrong with Iran, if there's a if Iran and Israel, amen, if there's a confrontation in that direction, amen, it's going to release most of the end time things that we have predicted. I mean, this could be, and they're predicting this very, very soon. So I know that all of us got future plans, but I want you to also keep in mind that you better plan for the coming of Christ soon. Amen. Amen. We need to really plan for that. So I have all of these things in my mind when I said pray at 5 o'clock, pray at 7 o'clock. I have all of these things in my mind. We might not even be here. Amen. Of course, some of us might be here even after Jesus comes. But this could be very, very, very soon. Amen. The seven signs that I shared with you, major signs, all of these signs have already come to pass. Amen. All of these signs, and all these are signs that will take place just before, amen, Jesus comes back to the earth. Amen. We know prior to His coming to the earth, He's coming back for His church. Okay, let's look at verse 8. Everybody together says this. The Lord is gracious. Everybody repeat that. The Lord is what?
Gracious.
And what? Full of compassion, slow to anger, and of great mercy. The Lord is good to all, and His tender mercies are over all of His works. Amen. Isn't that a good scripture?
Yes.
Amen. His tender mercies are over all of His works. You know, I was looking at through in His presence, Dr. David Kenyon, and I was reading a chapter that says, what produces the highest kind of faith? And he had seven things that we've studied before, but it was really interesting how that relates to what we're trying to get over. Amen. In this series of teaching, he says, number one, the integrity of the Word. We have to be convinced that God's Word is speaking to us. It's a revelation to God, to each one of us. Amen. It's not a doctrine. It's not a creed. It's not a philosophy. It's a personal Word. Amen. Whatever God is speaking, that is what? God's Word and God's revelation. Amen. To you personally. Amen. Sometimes we just glare over and just glance over these things. But whatever God is saying, amen, He's speaking to you, what? Personally. And we have to understand, amen, and value the integrity of the Word. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
All right, number two, He was saying the reality of our redemption. Amen. We have to believe that we have been, what? Redeemed. Bible says we've been what? Redeemed from the curse of the law. We've been delivered from the power of darkness. And that has to become reality. And I believe through affirming the Word. Amen. We're going to be affirming the reality, the new creation realities this week. Amen. All of these realities that really makes the Word of God real to us, we're going to be affirming these things in our prayer. That's the reason I'm so high on praying the Word. Amen. Some of us, amen, praise God, we need to get that vision. And so, amen, but when we pray the Word, that's the thing that makes the Word what? Reality.
Yes, amen.
That's the thing that gives you what? Joy.
Yes.
That's the thing that makes your life what? Full and complete.
Yes.
That's the thing that makes you feel like you can run, amen, run through troops and leap over a wall.
Yes.
That's one thing that can eradicate these what? Sad faces. Hey, hey, hallelujah, praise God. God is able, halamahasa. God is able to do exceeding. Amen. I feel like I can jump over that beam since the heel center right now. Amen. I'm not going to try it right now. Praise God. Amen. But God gives you what? Energy. He gives you what? Life. Bible says the entrance of His Word gives you what? Life. Give life. Hallelujah. And the Word says the Word is life to them that what? Find it. Amen. We're going to do everything we can, amen, to get the Word a living reality in your life. When the Word becomes real, amen, praise God. The Scripture says what? Amen. Nothing is impossible to them that what? Believe.
Yes.
When the Word becomes real, your faith becomes what? Alive. How many can say amen?
Amen.
And one way to do that, amen, pray the Word, affirm the Word, agree with the Word, amen, and sing the Word. Do everything you can, amen, because the more you do with the Word, the more the Word will what? Do with you or for you. How many believe that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I was really excited about that because it kind of fits into what the things that we're going to be sharing. We're going to be giving a lot of illustrations and demonstrations this week concerning, amen, how much God wants to bless you. He wants to bless you much more than what you really desire to be blessed. And you got to be convinced, and you got to what? Agree with those scriptures that gives us all of this information, how eager God is to what? How bad He wants to what? Bless us.
Amen.
Amen. You know, the only problem is that He can't go beyond His Word to what? To release His blessings into our life. Amen. He can't violate His moral law. Amen. Praise God. But when we can make it possible and open up the way, amen, place ourselves in a position where God's Word and God's blessings can be released into our lives, God is what? Scripture says His eyes, ooh, glory. His eyes are what? Running. Hey, see, amen. Hallelujah. So you don't have to beat the devil running. Amen. God's eyes are running. How many can say amen? Amen. They are running to Him. So see, God is eagerly waiting for the opportunity to what? To pour these blessings.